Hey guys, and welcome to another episode of Behind the Closed
Doors.
If you like what we do, subscribe to our channel, leave comments below, and of course smash that like button. But most of all, tell other people about it so we can grow our channel. Let's go! Okay, I'm back in the studio. You might wonder why it was so quiet on the Behind the Closed Doors front. Well, very simple. We've been very, very busy. And of course, during Christmas and New Year's, well, we only did a few workshops. And you actually saw those online. They were for Sony. And we took a little bit of a breather. And we actually got a new member of our family. I'm going to tell you a little bit about that in a moment. But most of all, we were preparing for something else. Now, you might recognize these cameras. They're Canon cameras. And, well, they're film cameras. So why do we have film cameras over here? Well, we actually filmed two whole new classes for Kelby One. So we have Gwan and Jason from the US over here in our studio. And we did two amazing classes for them. And they're going to be released in about a few weeks or a few months, you never know. But I'm sure you're going to love it. I'm going to tell you a little bit about that in a moment. Okay, now you might wonder, why didn't Frank film any behind the closed doors during the filming of the Kelby classes? Well, very simple. We want to make that a surprise for you guys. And we filmed some stuff that I simply can't show on behind the closed doors. For the very simple reason, well, it's a Kelby class, so it has to be a little bit of a surprise. But I can already tell you, you're absolutely gonna love these classes. We did one class in the studio where we did a lot of creativity. So we used grids, feathering, small softboxes, but also lens flares. What do you think about spraying water, using wet hairs, motion, and whatnot more. It was an absolutely amazing class. And the next day, we actually went outside. It was blistering cold. We even got hauled over by the police. That's a totally different story. And, well, we did a lot of stuff outside that I never did before on a video. So we show you how to fight the sun, how to mix ambient light. We did some cool tricks with gels. And every class is also ended with a retouch session. So from every setup, I choose one image. And I'm actually retouching that image and showing you everything from my workflow. That's going to be an amazing class. So make sure you check that out on Kelby One. Now, in this episode, I also want to show you something else. A while ago, I was approached by a guy in the Netherlands, and he had a really cool company. And I just loved his name. His name? Laserop.nl. Now, for English-speaking guys, it's like, why is that so funny? If you're in the Netherlands, you absolutely love the word joke. Laserop means something like, well, we have to beep that out, so sorry, guys, I can't translate that online. But anyway, it's a really cool wordplay. Now, it's a company that specializes in using lasers to actually put text on any material. And it got some really cool stuff in. So, something like this, and we'll close up later. Or this, and a USB stick with the Frank Doroff logo on it. And we got, and this is really cool, a keychain with a guitar, and even, well, a bottle opener. And the cool thing is, I was really enthusiastic when I got it in and I said, you know what, we're gonna film an episode with you guys and showing how the laser works. And they actually already sent me some video of the laser, so let me show you that now. In a future episode, you're gonna see me visit their company and, well, they're gonna explain to you how the laser works. And the nicest thing is, if you follow my social media, you know that starting off, well, the new year, well, we got a new member in our family called Chewy, and he's a small Labradoodle. He's about 13 weeks old now. And, well, I got a really cool gift from them. So they print literally everything. So I highly recommend check them out online. They're really cool guys, and the quality of the products is really nice. So if you have a pet in the Netherlands, well, of course, you don't want to lose your pet, so this is my name of the dog. And on the back side, there's actually my phone number. So if my dog gets lost, people can actually know how the dog is named. And they can bring him back by just calling the number on the back. So check them out online. They're called Laserop.nl. I just love that name. And I'm sure you're going to love their products. So today, wrapping up the classes for Kelby 1 and when they're released, it will be in about a few weeks or maybe a few months. Make sure you check them out on Kelby1.com. I'm sure you're absolutely going to love those classes. I think they're the best I ever did for Kelby 1. So, Annemiek, are you ready to go?
Yes.
Okay, let's go. And sorry, guys, we can't show you anything about the filming of the classes. But I promise you this. We're going to do a small interview with Jason and Guan from Kelby 1. And that's going to be the next scene. Hey guys, I'm here with Guan and Jason from Kelby 1, and we just filmed two whole new classes for Kelby 1. One on location and one in the studio. But of course you don't want to hear me talk, you want to hear the guys talk. So, Jason, can you please introduce yourself to our viewers?
Yeah, my name is Jason Stevens, and I'm a director, editor, videographer, and I also like to say I'm a photographer too. Learning from you and everyone else, but we've been taping. But I've been there for 1 year now.
1 year. Cool. Yep. And Guan.
Yeah, I'm Juan Alfonso. Been at Kelby Media for 11 years now. One of the editors, videographers, and yeah, I love learning from all these guys and just doing it. I love it.
You remember my first class I filmed with you? It was in Optica or something with the BMXer?
Yes.
That was terrible. It was like really, it was like 140 degrees or something.
Yeah, Florida gets really hot and humid, so.
Yeah.
And you're from over here, it gets nice and cold, and like right now it's cold, but. I remember it being really hot that day. Everybody was sweating pretty bad.
They always wonder why I wear shorts when I'm in America. Now you understand, now you're here, right?
Sure, yeah, yeah.
Because what you guys don't know yet is we filmed a class yesterday outside, and I was wearing a coat and gloves, and these guys, they were like, frozen popsicles. They were just, I had to wake them up, like, guys, wake up, unfreeze.
Yeah,
it was terrible.
I actually had to buy a coat for this class because I didn't even have a coat.
And what happened? we actually had the police chasing us with two cars, right?
Yeah, well, we had this model that, which is absolutely beautiful, and she does look younger, but she had a trench coat. So we were in a tunnel, and there was four of us men with the one young model. And there was lots of bicycles coming through the tunnel. And someone said that we were shooting nude photography
in this, with a minor.
With an underage girl. So I'm sitting there. Juan and I were actually taking some shots of the sheep.
Sheep, yeah.
Because we don't see sheep in Florida. And all of a sudden, I look around and a police officer comes right up. And he's like, and he starts talking in Dutch, and I was like, English. And he's like, what are you doing here? And we're like, we're shooting a training video. And he's like, well, are you here by yourself? I was like, no. And then Frank came around the corner, and then...
I saw two police cars. I was going like, I have to go around the corner. This is going wrong.
Yeah. But I thought the funniest thing about this story, I thought, was because they got Frank's ID, the model's ID, and your grip's ID. We're foreigners, and they didn't ask us for our passports.
Yeah, we have
or
all the gear.
All
At one point, we're very glad that the police actually responded that fast, but with two cars. The thing that frustrated me, it was not the response of the police, but it was actually the guy calling it in. Like, there's a minor being shot in the nude in a tunnel. Like, how does he come up with that? Because it was so cold. She was wearing a trench coat. She was wearing leggings and three parts of clothing. So
I think the trench coat.
Yeah, because you think like the flashers.
Oh, the red trench coat.
Yeah.
That could be it.
Yeah.
Lois is very, very glad now that she's being called a minor because she's like 21 or 22.
Yeah.
So she's now she's going like, yeah, I'm younger. Hey, the classes we filmed, did you like it over here?
Oh, absolutely. I thought, first of all, your skills, you got the skills. You're amazing. And just the things, the images you came out with just the one flash blew me away, you know. So, and then we did all the different locations. So we were in the tunnel, the field, basically.
The road.
Yeah, the road with a huge field behind. And then we were on the canal and then against a warehouse, basically, just a wall, which you would never think. Really, I never thought of taking a model shot there, but he did it.
Yeah, I'm always fascinated with how you guys are able just to walk out into almost any location and just make fabulous photos every single time. Like we said, we walked around the studio, walked down the street a couple times, and just what you would not think would make a good image always makes a pretty powerful, exciting image, especially with the lighting that you use. It was pretty neat.
Now, I'm a big advocate for using, for example, like the X-Rite color checkers. X-Rite is also a sponsor, of course, of Behind Closed Doors, so an X-Rite color checker. But I saw you using also something. Now, a lot of you guys out there, when you do photography or you do video, you don't think about color temperature or about white balance. Now, when you do video, it's actually incredibly important. And you had a really cool app on your phone because I saw you constantly metering the light for color temperature. Can you explain a little bit about
that? The Cinemeter 2 is the one I use, and basically, it gives you a waveform, and then the biggest thing what we're looking for is matching all the cameras with the color temperature. And this app, which is only $30, and then you put a dome around it on your iPhone on the camera, and that's another $30. So you're $60 for a portable light meter, where you know they're much more expensive than
that. It's a color meter. It's actually not a light meter. It's a color meter because you see everything. Okay. Yep. I was really, really interested. Yeah. So it's cool. Now they have to find it for Android.
Yeah, because we actually, for Frank's class, which I think this is the first class, we had five cameras rolling. So we're going to multicam his lessons together in Premiere. Yeah. And so we had the 5D Mark III, two C100s. We had
a Canon M3.
Canon M3 and the GoPro.
And you borrowed my DJI Pocket.
Which is amazing. The DJI Pocket, we're getting it when we get back.
I love it too. It's so smart. But you know the cool thing, especially when you travel, and I saw you doing the behind the scenes, it's you just hold it in your hand and you just do it. And the same thing with the police. If you have a C100 and you put it in front of the police, they will probably just arrest you.
Correct.
And you were holding the DJI. I hope you pressed the record. I don't know if you did.
Well, I only, actually, when the police came, I just took up that really nice pano that you posted.
Yeah.
With
I
my
will put
iPhone.
That below.
Yeah. So I did a real quick pano, and I took a couple snapshots, and they looked at me at first, and then they started posing, the cops, because they liked the attention.
Welcome in Emmeloord.
Yeah.
Okay, so what we always do during these is we give a 1 second tip, and of course they can be a little bit longer than 1 second, but if you have to give a video or photography tip, what is your 1 second tip?
The more mobile you are, the better. Like, so we're running, we call this run and gun, what we're doing with you. So obviously you would love to have like a whole crew and do lighting and stuff. So we rolled with two flex lights and two cameras on the, I mean, we added the other cameras just for, cause we had time to do that. But if we didn't have time, we had the one camera each and one flex light each, and we could get what we needed.
It's the same with Anna Week and I do. We have one camera, and when we do instructional videos, we can run up to five. Mm-hmm. But we have actually one camera and a little portable light, and you just run. And a lot of people don't realize that you get the best images that way, because if you make it stable, the thing is, it's stable, it's fixed. And when you run and gun, you can actually just move around. That's why I'm a big fan of tripods when you need a tripod. Mm-hmm. But for example, in the studio, you see a lot of people shooting from tripods, and I always tell them, like, why? Because you limit yourself to only one position. Now, outside, when you shoot on lower shutter speeds or landscapes, or when we do compositing or whatever, I love tripods. But it's the same thing you say. Don't, and I think that's a great tip, don't make it too fixed, because you have to be able to move around.
Yep.
Your 1 second tip.
I think, for me, I think prep is a big thing. I've been tuning long enough, so I know when I show up to a certain location, I'm going to have certain camera settings. And I think I like certain camera settings ahead of time.
Learn
at least
gear.
Get it close, you know, and then we'll decide on what lens to use and this and that. So I think setting camera settings beforehand is before you reach your location.
Totally agree.
Yeah. Just know your gear.
Totally
agree. Know your gear for sure.
Yeah, because you could spend, as you know, like you could, if you don't have your camera, like if it's all like set up for something else, you could spend like a good 15 minutes just getting, I'm exaggerating a little bit. I mean, you could spend a good amount of several minutes just going through the menus of your camera and getting everything where it needs to be. So
especially, again, working with so many cameras, you want to have as much as possible ready.
You won't believe this. I teach a lot of workshops, and you don't want to know how many people come in here and they, for example, they have a Sony camera and they already have the camera for like a year. And they come up to me and they say, Frank, you have to explain me one thing. You're a big Sony fan. I hate Sony in the studio. And I go like, why? He said, because the only time I see my model is when I press the focus button, and I go, oh, yeah, you didn't put setting effect off, right? And they go like, excuse me? Mm. And they already have the camera for a year, and they're studio photographers. And they don't know that in the menu, if you set the setting effect of off, it just works as an OVF. And the same thing happens with people that can't trigger the strobes. and they go through the camera and they don't know where, for example, it says like on the Sonys, if you have, for example, a problem with tethering, it's because you already have your smartphone activated. So you have to deactivate the smartphone and then you can do tethering.
Yep.
With certain cameras like the Fuji, if you use the live view, your studio strobe won't fire. With certain Nikons, you have the same problem with Canon. You don't want to know how many people I tell actually during a workshop, the best tip I can give you is reset your camera every week and then set it up again.
Mm-hmm.
Reset it after a week, set it up again until you're so fed up with it that you know the menu by heart.
Mm-hmm.
Because the thing is, if you're relaxed at home, reading a comic or whatever, and you have to set up your camera, you have time. But in the field, it happens so many times that a model is balancing on a ledge, almost falling down. It's freezingly cold. Yeah. We have my client behind me going like, Frank, it's cold. We're already over time. It's costing us 5,000 euros a minute that you're going over time. And at that point, you have to find something in your menu and you go like, uh-oh. So learn your gear by heart.
Yep.
But in all honesty, I'm a little bit disappointed by you two.
Oh, yeah.
I would have expected the 1 second tip to get a subscription to Kelby One.
Oh, yeah.
Because there are so many more tips. So make sure you check out KelbyOne.com because it's absolutely amazing. They have everything about photography and retouching and whatnot more. Without any doubt, I'm one of all, I'm very proud to be part of the member of literally a dream team of instructors.
Oh, yeah, mm-hmm. That's wonderful.
But most of all, the quality, the production quality is absolutely stunning. If you like our instructional videos, oh, man, you really have to check out Kelby One. It's absolutely stunning. And Anouk actually has a little gift for our guests from the United States. Right, Anouk? Mm-hmm. So just hand him over the gift. Now we want you on camera because people absolutely love you. Oh, she first has to check out. There we go.
Well, Jason, thank you for coming. Here's a little token of our appreciation.
Awesome.
Juan, thank you too.
Thank you so much.
Why fake it when you can create it? Yeah, thank
love
you.
It. Thank you.
You're more than welcome.
FrankDoroff.com. Awesome. Yeah, and I just want to reiterate too, like, because I totally agree with him. Like, I have been, and I told you this story earlier, like, I've been a video guy, and ever since I joined Kelby One, like, I have absolutely fallen in love with photography because of the instructors. And, I mean, we're behind the camera, but we're learning with you guys. So these instructors are amazing.
Yeah,
awesome.
I think, you know, along with that is like, yeah, I've been there a long time and I've seen a lot of instructors come through. But if you're not out there practicing, you're not, you can learn as much as you want, but if you're not practicing, you're not going to get it.
Learn every single day and try different stuff. Never do the same thing again.
Yep.
Thank you so very much for being
Thank
here.
You.
I loved having you guys.
Yep. Thank you.
Thank you so very much. And guys, again, check out KelbyOne.com. In about a month, I believe my classes will be online. So that's really fast. You have to check it out.
Yeah, we're editing them.
Yeah, you're editing them. And we're just going to have some fun in Urk and get some fish. Are you ready, guys?
We're ready.
Let's go. I've been trying to find my way. Take me by the head and let's go find our own space. Somewhere in between you and me. It's a piece of magic that we need to release. Ooh, and now you're looking for a good time. I think you should take a chance with me. And do you wanna get the mood right? I think you should take a chance with me. Cause I've been on my way. I've been on my way for a long, long time. You've been on your way. Take a chance, take a chance with me.
You are free.